So I might owe you a little bit of an apology. I took a break for the past few weeks, which I was not planning to do, and that break ended up being much longer than I would have liked. So sorry about that kind of dry spell with videos. I have no excuse. I do recall promising you a review of More Than Meets the Eye Volume 1, and I will definitely do that because this is a comic that deserves to be reviewed. But I think for now, since I've been off for so long, it'd be best to just get back into the habit of watching episodes with you guys and doing reactions and stuff, because you guys have been patiently waiting and my subscriber count has been going up despite the fact that I haven't really been doing anything. So thank you for being very patient and bearing with me until I managed to sit down in front of my computer and talk to a screen again. Okay, so enough of that. We're here to watch episode 8 of Micron Legend. This episode is called Palace in English. I don't know what it's called in Japanese. Probably the title is in Japanese words, because that's how language works. Hopefully I haven't lost my touch. You know, I was going to say something stupid, but it's not important. Why hold back? That's what we're here for. Entertain us. Here we are now. Entertain us. Well, probably no deaths will happen, considering it's pretty early in the series. What kind of show would kill off a character in the first few episodes? Or the first episode, or the first 5 minutes of the first episode? That was still really weird that you did that, Transformers Prime. Oh, for Christmas, I got, like, this is kind of just me bragging about what happened that's good in my life, but I got seasons 2 and 3 of Transformers Prime and Predacons Rising all on DVD, so I now own the complete series. That will not impact the show in any way. I've already done reactions for all of the episodes and movie that I got for Christmas. I just wanted to share it because I'm happy about it. Christmas is good. Not for everyone, though. If Christmas isn't good for you, that's fine. But it was good for me this year. Some people really hate Christmas, like, not because they're Scrooges or anything, but because of, like, personal reasons. And that's fine. If your ideal Christmas is sitting under your quilt and watching Breaking Bad, or whatever it is people watch, I don't know what people do, on Netflix for hours, that's cool. Sounds like a good day to me. Never noticed it before, but it looks like the word producer on the credits is in katakana, which is the Japanese alphabet that you use to spell English words using Japanese syllables. Is there not a word for producer in Japanese? Seems like a no-brainer. Okay, anyway. Look, Mommy, I'm riding the camel! Shut up, Jeff Corwin. This is another scene where there is, everyone likes to point out that woman looks like Starscream. Like, she has the exact same face. If that even is a woman. Rad identifies it as a woman in the narration, which only exists in English. This seems like there should be narration, though. Like, usually when the dub adds narration and it's not there in the Japanese version, when you watch the Japanese version, it works without words. But here, it seems like something's missing. And the narration wasn't even good, but it just seems like there should be dialogue there. Wow, that's a great still of sand. At least they didn't do what the Powerpuff Girls remake did and just use a stock photo of the Sahara Desert. Like, they did that. A professional cartoon did that. Wow. I mean, this show is well known for cutting corners and it's a well-earned reputation, but damn, a stock photo? I'm sure you would have heard of it by now if I had. And to shoot at anything that flies by, even though none of the Autobots that are on Earth right now can fly. I was thinking about names the other day for Transformers, and I realized that the name Cyclonus for this character in English Makes a lot of sense. Like, because helicopter blades spin in a circle. And that's how they fly, and they kick up a lot of wind whenever they're near. So the name Cyclonus actually makes much more sense for a helicopter guy than it does for some grumpy purple guy who turns into who the fuck cares. And whose voice actor can't seem to decide on the type of delivery he wants to give it. And who I'm sure we won't be seeing in 2017 in any Transformers-related media, no sir. Ah! I'm melting! What have you done to me? Enterprise, what we received didn't live long, fortunately. I don't know why I did this. They don't do this in Star Trek. Treasure Shrine? It's a generic name. I assume it sounds better in Japanese, maybe? You are wildly unprepared for Earth's terrain in general. That's right, I'm your senpai. And I am not going to notice you. Watch is an overrated show.
Hey, hey.
I have actually never seen Yo-Kai Watch. I don't know how good it is. I think. Hope it's not Starscream. I'm gonna shoot anyway, though. We are not good at this. We should comb the desert. They get giant combs and start dragging them through the sand. Wait, found shit! What are we doing here? I already have melanoma. I've already been out here for 10 seconds, but already. Wow! You guys got really far, really fast! I'm thirsty. Shut up, Carlos. Seriously, people ignore Optimus Prime all the time. What's the point of having a commanding officer if you're just gonna kind of not do what he says ever? Yeah, yeah, he shot you, just like I told you he would, dumbass. Typical day on the set of the 2007 Transformers movie. What is that visor thing for if it doesn't help you aim? Those kids are really fast. They are part Sidewinder. Or camel? Camels aren't known for their speed, though. Ah, oh, what happened? Sandworm from Dune got him. How many times can I reference things that I've never seen? They walk through the sand quickly, but they fall super slowly. Ow, wrist, ow, ow, ow. I don't know if we gotta. It seems more like a you want to thing to me. Did I remind you that Demolisher is a desert tank? Sand isn't water. You can't just fall right through it. Ah! It's rough and coarse and it's getting everywhere! I said we're losing contact with Ironhide. I heard what you said! It was an exclamatory what, not an interrogative what. What? What the hell are children? Why is this happening? A massive sinkhole open for no reason. Maybe it's pet again. Ah ha ha! Ah ha 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 ha! Better than calling out for Megatron Sama. I mean, who has he ever pulled out of a burning building? Oh. Ah, they didn't sink into a sinkhole, they just went to another dimension. We do not look integrated with this background at all. There's like no shading underneath them. The cells have been placed onto a painting. That's all that happened. Which is how it usually works, but you also have shadows as a separate cell so that you don't look like someone just dragged you there, clip art. Carlos is the one I am the most concerned for. Fuck those other two. What are their names? Dude and Kelly or something. It is a miracle that we are not dead. We should at least be hacking our lungs inside out. Does anybody have eye drops? You ever notice that their eyes change size in between different scenes, different episodes? Like, sometimes they're huge, like stereotypical anime eyes, and sometimes they're much more reasonably sized. Pick a model and stick with it! This is a very slow episode. You're right there and I can't hit you because... He immediately sinks. I warped over here. Have you seen the kids? They'll be fine. They can eat sand and scorpions to survive. Aww, call them senpai. You stop with your terms. Yep, it's a Micron panel. And you figured out the water effect on iMovie. And that looks like a crappy postcard. Uh-huh. Oh my god, that's hideous. Cut away from this scene. Who are we? What is our purpose? We must evolve. Evolve! I feel like a lot was revealed there. I feel like this show wouldn't be the same without those abysmal colored backgrounds. Like, seriously, what was the point of that? Some people found the Micron panel. They looked at each other. They lived in fucking Corona labeled world. What the hell is sand? Actually, as we found out this year, you don't have to know what the pyramids are for to be president. Heart! Actually, the Egyptians are speculated to be the ones who came up with the heart-shaped symbol, so that might be kind of clever, I think, maybe. But I feel like attributing actual historical references to this show, like historical accuracy, would be overestimating it. Also, in one scene in Energon, the Temple of Ramses is visible in one establishing shot. Like, the actual, it's like drawn and colored accurately so that it looks like the real Temple of Ramses. It's so weird. Like, why? Can you leave that super famous archaeological site out of your crappy show, please? It's like, what have you done with Ironhide? Oh. Ironhide. He's like thinking hard. Is he the guy with the southern accent? No, that's not him. I got over that whole where is Ironhide thing pretty fast. I see you. I see you, halfling. He called her Alexa-kun? Oh my god, floating eyes. They're judging us. They think our Orange jumpsuits are tacky and weeaboo-ish. Probably just the wind. It often sounds like the screams of frightened children. What are those? Yeah, that's a valid question. Why do they... Why are these? Why? You know what would have been cool to see in that flashback? Why the fuck the ancient Egyptians somehow had giant Omnicrons? Or whatever they're called. What's the name of that thing from The Incredibles? I'm pretty sure it was called the Omnicron. Like, what's it powered by? Some sort of hydraulic system making the legs go and making them target small children? I'm like, thanks for saving us, Ironhide! Bye! I mean, yeah, there's nothing else I could do, but... kinda dickish. Kinda wondering how they got the sound effect for the shots. Because, like, lasers have that kind of, like, buzzy noise. Like in Star Wars, they made it by hitting a suspension cable. That doesn't sound like what they're using here. It doesn't sound like normal gunfire. I'm not sure Cartoon Network would allow that anyway. Ha, are? That was cute. He makes anime noises. You abducted him, didn't you, son? He starts shooting at the sun. Starscream just goes, oh. I'm not with him. I don't. He's old, just be nice to him. I hate to say it, but this episode kind of needs the narration from the English dub. And again, the narration wasn't good. It was dumb and Rad just pointing out the obvious, but without it, it's just like, this is the screensaver show. There's just like nothing. If the, like, scenes were more spectacular or anything, it would be different, but this is just... No, it's not worthy of that reaction, Carlos. It's just a still image with some cheap After Effects. Oh, what fresh nonsense is this? More things breaking, that's new. Like their faces start melting. How do they set this up? How do they do this? Did the Micron panel make this possible? How? I have no idea what's going on in this episode. I'm so lost. It's just like watching Combiner Wars all over again. Like, yeah, okay, the Transformers were capable of magic in Prime, and magical, like, supernatural happenings happened in the G1, but that was in the 80s. Like, this is just, like, it seemed like Earth was, like, mundane and normal existence, and then, like, all the fantastic stuff happens when the Transformers appear, but then there's this fucking Egyptian temple with glowy pyramid-shaped... holding cell like it's this one of those cagey shield thingies from Pokemon movies. And then laser shooting Anubis statues. I don't understand. I never truly comprehended before this night how weird this episode is. That looks heavy. See what I meant about the eyes? They're way bigger than they were earlier. I saw it first! Demolisher has determination. Look at him, not falling, despite everything falling around him. That was a panel from the Lone Wolf and Ironhide comic. Ha 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 ha. Oh shit, gravity. Now I can drive up the falling sand when I couldn't earlier. I don't care, it's almost over. Did you take Ironhide whole? Actually, yes, that wasn't an insane thing to say this time. Starscream just remembered that sand exists. Truly a frightening realization. We need to clear out my lungs that I have. You named it Bomb? Bomb! Its name is fucking Bomb, dude. Like I care. Okay, that's kind of funny, but the English line is way funnier. And in case you don't know what it is, when Hotshot asks, "What have you done with the humans?" Demolisher responds, "I ate them." And they were quite tasty too. It's like one of the few, like, actually funny in its own right jokes from Armada. Because he just, like, smiles and says that. It's just such a no shits given scene. I love it. I love Demolisher. Demolisher's okay. Of course, Ironhide's "Like I Care" is funny, but it's not as funny. Bomb shoots lasers. That makes sense. No. I mean, I guess it's kind of like when we in America made Kung Fu Panda and we named the tortoise Oogway, which means tortoise. Like, that probably sounds stupid to a Chinese viewer. Despite that, Kung Fu Panda is really popular in China. Go figure. These are the same kids, right? I'm sure that if you reach into the Sahara Desert, you'll just pluck up some random children. It's like a Cabbage Patch. I feel like we accomplished a lot today. I agree. The music didn't really fit the mode, like, we lost and we almost died, and it sucked. Nani Ohota! But he sank into the thing and he's still on the cross and you're punishing him? Megatron is full of bullshit. Please approach me. I'm not sure I want to find out what happens next. Pan out! I like that. I think Starscream's just happy that someone else is on the receiving end of Megatron's bullshit for once. Okay. I cannot believe I'm about to say the words that I am contemplating saying at this moment. But they are true, and I have to say them no matter how ridiculous they sound. This episode was better in English. God, it physically hurt me to say that. But it's true, and it's not just the thing about the narration. Some of the dialogue and some of the jokes were just better. Like, the conversation when Sandstorm flies in and greets Ironhide. It maybe made more sense in Japanese and established more for the joke later, like Ironhide's supposed to be on the lookout, but he ended up finding the Minicon, and then Megatron uses that excuse to get the Minicon from him. None of that was English dub, but instead the dialogue seemed like more playful and lively, with like Cyclonus making a joke about having sand in places he'd rather not mention, and I don't know, they just seemed more awake. And the dialogue at the end between Megatron and Demolisher, where Demolisher doesn't want to give Megatron the Minicon, I'm getting terms confused between different language versions. And Megatron insisting over and over is funnier in English because it comes across like a dad, like, scolding a misbehaving kid. And that's kind of what they were going for in Japanese, I think, but it was much stronger in English. So yeah, I was not expecting to find episodes that are better in English than they are in Japanese. That is really a surprise. And it's kind of a pleasant one, because it means that Cartoon Network, or Voice Box, which did the dubbing for the show, were not completely incompetent, that they did actually manage to squeeze something from nothing at times. Though I think what might be happening is the Japanese version is suffering from the show being released in America first, so that they have to write around what the studio wanted for America otherwise. Instead of America having to write around what Japan presents first. But again, I don't know that for sure because there's very little information available in general about what went on behind the scenes for this show. I think it'd be fascinating to learn more about it, but as is, we don't know much. But anyway, that was episode 8, Treasure Shrine. Great name, A+, that's good. yeah, kind of a surprise, but I enjoyed watching with you guys, even if it was lousy. It's still educational, even if it is lousy. So I hope you guys had a good holiday and have a good new year. 2016 was rough for everyone, and we have no guarantee that 2017 will be better. But as long as we believe that it can be better, I think we'll do okay. That's my creed. So hopefully the next video will be more than meets the eye review that I keep promising. But if it's not, you will definitely get a video tomorrow, because I'll tell you what, I have gone too long with no activity, and I don't want to get behind on these Armada episodes since there's so many of them. So I feel like I want to keep the episodes going at a much more rapid pace than I have in the past. So look forward to that. I certainly am. This is Dragon Keeper 9600 signing off.